A memorial honoring two sons is about to get a facelift. As we first told you last week, someone vandalized the monument. And as Kathleen O'Toole explains live from the tech center, a Sebastian company has stepped up to help a grieving mother. Kathleen?
Tiffany, many people were touched by this story. First, a mother lost her son to a double murder. Then she had to endure the pain of his memorial being vandalized.
Like your other one, can you see it?
Carol Michael returns to the site of her son's memorial, but this time it's not nearly as painful.
You're good, honey, you're good.
The work of vandals that our news report detailed last week is still there. Someone intentionally scratched out the face of Carol's son, David Lee, and that of another murder victim, Michael Teat.
Why would someone do that? Why?
Carol was crushed, then the community came forward.
So it was fantastic for me to see how many people were reaching out. I was crying actually when I was talking on the phone.
One of those calls came from Sebastian. It was the owner of Everlasting Stoneworks.
This is a cameo.
A mother of three herself, Jamie Hicks, could not stand by after learning of Carol's pain.
The money, it's really not that much, you know, so I'd like to help her.
Hicks will donate new portraits. The natural thing to do, she says, for her first husband was also murdered.
For her to go and see something like that done to her child's stone, it must be really bad.
And so I can't wait to meet her.
Carol Michael, floored by the gesture, is taking care to make sure the new pictures will fit perfectly. Spirits lifted, that goodness prevailed.
Does it give you any comfort?
Yes, because I see there's a lot of good people out there still, and they don't even know me. I didn't recognize any of their names. They're just people who saw the story and were touched by it. I can't wait to see his face smiling there again, where it belongs.
Now, Carol Michael is no stranger to loss. It was in 2006 that her youngest son was killed by a hit-and-run driver while he walked on North Island Way in Jupiter. That driver was never found. Kathleen O'Toole, WPBF 25 News.